Hey guys, do you want to become a better infielder within 10 minutes? My name is Doug Bernier from Pro Baseball Insider, and I'm going to give you 5 keys that will make you a better infielder within 10 minutes. All right, tip number 1, glove presentation. Now, if you only use one of these keys, this is the one to use. When we present our glove, we want to do it early. A lot of infielders will kind of pat their glove as the ball's coming and then try to time the ball. Timing a moving object, trying to catch it with another moving object, is difficult. Get it out there early, feel like we're waiting for the baseball. Now, how we present our glove, we want our fingers pointed to the ground. We want the heel of our glove pointed out. This will allow for more of the surface area of the glove to be used. So as we're fielding this baseball, I'm gonna have it this way opposed to this way. When the back of the hand is on the ground, you create a ramp and you can see not as much surface area of the glove is being used. So make sure we have our fingers down, the palm of our heel out. That is key number 1. That is the most important thing you can change right away to see instant results. All right, tip number 2. After we presented our glove properly, make sure we are properly lined up. Now, a quick little thing I want to show you. When we drop our hand from our shoulder, you can see my hand is in line with you, and that's where the direction that the ball is coming from. The further I move to the right, you can see now my hand is pointing this way. It's not pointing at you. So we want to make sure our glove is open to where the ball's coming from, and we want to make sure it's all lined up. So kind of a rule of thumb, feel the ball somewhere between our belly button and our glove side knee. For me, it's my left knee. So when I'm in here, my glove is fully open and it's facing the direction that the ball's coming from. Very important. As we go down to field this baseball, make sure the ball, the glove, and the eyes are all lined up. So even if we happen to field out this way, make sure we get our eyes in this direction. If we're more in the middle of our body, our eyes are already there, but the glove, the ball, and the eyes are lined up. That is tip number 2. All right, so now that we've got our glove presented properly, we are lined up. Now it's time for tip number 3, stay low. It is a lot easier to come up on a ball than it is to be high and go down. So as the ball's coming in, make sure we're in good posture, we're in our legs, our butt's up, and we have our glove on the ground. What this does too is when we are low to the ground, our eyes are closer to the baseball. Almost feel like you're underneath the ball. I know that's not going to happen, but feel like you're underneath the ball. When you are, you're going to see the ball better and you're going to be able to react better in case the ball hops up. Again, it's a lot easier to come up. Stay low. That is tip number 3. All right, tip number 4, keep the feet moving. Now, a good rule of thumb, right, left, field. As we approach this ball and the ball's coming to us, we want to stay in control of the baseball. Once we stop moving our feet, now we give control to the baseball. Let's keep it on our side, so we gotta keep our feet moving. Now, when I say keep our feet moving, it doesn't mean we gotta run through the baseball wildly and out of control. No, not at all. Right, left, field. We can do it that slow. We can have that sort of movement. It doesn't have to be an aggressive move, but if we have some sort of momentum, we're on the balls of our toes, we're moving through the baseball, even if it's ever so slight, we stay in control of the ball. We've all been there before where we see that ball hit maybe about 5 feet out in front of us and we're just like, oh no. We get on our heels and we sit there and just wear it and get eaten up. Do the best that you can to keep the feet moving, stay on your toes and see if you can stay through the baseball. That keeps you in control. That is tip number 4. All right, tip number 5, get a 4-seam grip. Now, you're not gonna be able to do it every time, especially on a slow roller or a play. You have to get the ball out as quickly as possible. But I'm pretty sure you could do it on probably 90% of ground balls. The reason we wanna get a 4-seam grip, obviously when we get that, we're gonna get some consistency in our backspin, the ball's gonna fly the same way, and we're gonna get more on our throws. Whenever I'd throw, I had a little bit of a lower arm angle. My ball would have a little bit of sink to it. But I knew that because I would throw the ball the same way with the same grip every time. So if you can do that, even if you have a little movement, you can play that movement when you throw, but you know what you're gonna be getting when you let go of the ball. So tip number 5 is make sure you get a 4-seam grip. Also, no matter where you hold the ball, or however the ball is in your hand, you are no more than a quarter turn away from getting that 4-seam grip. So don't be afraid of it. Work on it in practice when you're playing catch. This is a key thing. It will make your throws a lot more consistent, and that is tip number 5. Hey guys, so that is my 5 keys to seeing results within 10 minutes for being a better infielder. Use those, see what happens, and your coaches and your teammates are gonna be excited when they see those quick results.